Hey, what's going on, gang? Brian here, Brian's Law Maintenance. Hey guys, wanted to do a quick video for you guys about what does it take to go full-time in lawn care. Let's check it out. All right, gang, this is gonna be a video I'm excited about doing, but also a little anxious about doing as well, because I'm gonna put out a couple disclaimers already off the bat that if you make any choices or decisions based off of what I say or the content that I put out, I am not being held responsible, okay? The reason I wanted to put this video together is because, especially in the last 8 weeks getting into the season, I've had numerous emails, numerous texts, Instagram comments, everything in between, asking people, hey, what does it take to go full-time in lawn care? And you know what? It's kind of a redundant topic because I've seen a lot of videos out there from some guys talking about what they did to go full-time in lawn care. In fact, congrats to my friend Andy on Cut and Clean Lawn Care. He just quit his job as well about 2 weeks ago at the time of this recording to go full-time in lawn care. So it's a really popular topic that a lot of guys want to know, but there's not always a lot of X's and O's behind it. Let me give you guys my two cents about what it takes to actually go full-time in lawn care, and let me give you some of the thought process behind making that decision. I don't have a background in accounting, I don't have a background in finance, and I think a lot of guys that get into lawn care, they start going from working factory jobs or warehouse jobs, or maybe even blue-collar, white-collar, really nice jobs, and you're making more in lawn care on the side than sometimes your weekly paycheck, Monday through Friday. And you know what? That was kind of my scenario. Up front, let me give you guys my idea of what it might take to go full-time in lawn care, and then for real, please watch the video all the way through, because I want you to understand the ramifications, the qualifications, the ideas and concepts, and the thought process that I'm going to give you guys, or at least my two cents about how to back up that decision, okay? But here's the bottom line. You have a business, it creates revenue, you have expenses, and that's your profit. When your profit is equal to your job income, from my opinion, you may want to evaluate flushing your job and going full-time in lawn care. All right, let me give you my five or six disclaimers and thoughts behind this. I don't have a script by any means. I'm just coming at you guys real talk, okay? Here's how you might want to hedge against that decision, meaning you may want to evaluate some other things on the background that a lot of guys have common misconceptions or questions about how to handle certain things. Number one, let's talk about healthcare and benefits. I'm not gonna give you guys all the X's and O's about what I do, but here's a tip. If you're having insurance at your job and it's $400 a month, go make $400 a month in your own business and cover that same expense. Let me give you another one. What do I do in the winter? I don't know what you're gonna do in the winter. Most of you guys have a 4 month winter, kind of like we do up here. Some of you guys only have a 2 month winter. If you're working a factory job or just some other job, ask them, hey, can I come back for 3 or 4 months in the fall, the winter, just to hedge and keep that income coming in, whether you need it or not, whether you're doing snow or not, okay? It's not that complicated. Figure it out. Let's talk about buying expensive equipment and financing it. Hey, here's a tip. You financed everything else in life, figure out a way to buy that lawnmower, that trailer, that truck, and wrap that payment into your revenue of your business and have your business pay for it. What I'm trying to say is if you make $700 a week at your job, but you're making $700 days doing lawn care and landscaping, your income should be more to offset the responsibilities you have buying other things to fund your business, okay? I'm gonna use Andy and Cut and Clean as an example because I had a conversation with him literally probably the week or two before he put in his 2 week notice. And I'm not saying that I've influenced that decision at all. In fact, I know him and I were cutting up over the phone right before he probably made that decision, and he was laughing saying I make blank in a week, and I said that's cool, and I wasn't trying to be a jerk or a hero, but I said that's cool, but you can make that in a day doing lawn care landscaping. And here's a tip, Andy knows that, and I think that's one of the reasons he went full-time in his lawn and landscape business. And you know what, that's totally cool, but you guys got to understand there's a method to the madness on the back end. A lot of these guys, even Andy with his personality type the way it is, very sanguine and very funny, that's not my personality type, as you guys know, I guarantee you he's still running the numbers. He's still looking at the X's and O's to evaluate if leaving his job was a good decision or not. Again, gross revenue minus your expenses is your profit. When that equals your job, you need to get out there as fast as possible, in my opinion. And a lot of you guys don't want to hear stuff like this because you want to have 20 disclaimers and you want to battle me and you guys want to argue about things. And again, this is business mindset. This is tough talk. If you don't like it, sorry, this video is not for you. but you guys want to know how to go full-time in lawn care, you have to make that decision and make it right. You guys have heard things like that. You guys have watched movies where somebody's in the ring fighting, and the guy says, what are you fighting for? I'm fighting for milk. Okay, these are real things that you guys need to have that aggressive personality. You're not gonna just go into lawn care landscaping and quit your job, and it's gonna be fluff. Another quote I love, it's all over memes, and I love memes and I hate them at the same time because everybody does it, but an entrepreneur is the only one that works 80 hours a week to avoid working 40 hours a week. Okay, there's another one that I like, half days. Everybody thinks an entrepreneur and a business owner works half the days, you know, they're done by noon. It's quite the opposite, actually. You work 12-hour days. My employees, when they get done at 3, 4, 5 p.m., they go home and they go live the dream. They go to the lake, they go fishing, they go boating, they go to the movies, they have fun. You know what I'm doing at 8 o'clock at night sometimes? Grinding out lawnmower blades. You know what I'm doing at 8 o'clock at night? Blowing somebody's backyard with clippings, covered in mosquitoes, because we just got behind and we have to pick up the slack because we had a rain out there. See, one thing that I really want to hammer home is that most people in the last 10 years did not grow up with this thought process of figure it out, put some muscle behind it, and put some ambition behind it, put some discipline behind it. Everybody wants it easy, and there's nothing out there like that. No other business, no other thing, including lawn care. And it bothers me when people disrespect being a full-time entrepreneur or business owner because they're not willing to pay the full price. You guys gotta understand, it's a mentality. It's a do whatever it takes. It's a I'm gonna make this thing work mentality. I don't know how you're gonna figure out your health care. I don't know how you're gonna figure out a new F-250 truck payment. I don't know how you're gonna figure out your winter income. I don't know where you're gonna get your experience doing mulch and landscaping. Watch YouTube videos. I got started 10 years ago and it's a miracle I'm even here, still successful and making money the way we are. You guys have access to the best guys out there. I'll tell you like a friend, my videos and my video quality, they're getting better, but I'm nowhere compared to a lot of these other guys. Watch their channels, watch how to bid jobs, watch how to make money doing landscaping. It's insane. There's so much knowledge out there. And I figure there's only two camps out there if you really wanna put it down. There's guys that are willing to work really, really hard and they think really, really small, or guys that dream big and make memes all day but they don't work at all and they're not making any effort and progress to accomplishing their dreams and goals. So which one are you? I think you guys need to just go hit it. Figure it out. You know, here's a tip. I don't know what you guys are gonna do for winter income. You know what you guys are all doing right now? You're all watching the lawn care videos, and that's totally cool. By the way, if you like this one, shoot it a thumbs up. Share it with a friend. But you know what I'm doing right now? I'm watching nothing but snow removal videos because I wanna plow snow and make 50,000 bucks in the winter doing that. Okay, I've already got the lawn care thing figured out. I don't wanna go back to part-time construction jobs and warehouse jobs because I'm still figuring things out too, guys. But the income that we make through our winter doing stupid little side jobs is nothing compared to the income we make doing lawn care and landscaping. But what really boggles my mind and triggers my brain is guys saying things like they make 2/3 of their income doing snow removal. I know what I make doing lawn care. I just want to make the big money doing snow as well so I got a full-time income. Okay, so guys, here's the mentality behind it. Figure it out. You have your gross revenue minus your expenses, that's your profit. When your profit equals your job, get out of there. You know what? Here's another big buzzword that you guys are looking for is opportunity cost. You might make $500 to $1,000 a week at your job. You can make that in a day doing lawn care landscaping, but because you're stuck at your job, and most of you guys probably feel this way, you're stuck at your job, you can't go bid that job. You can't go bid that mulch job. Now, transition a little bit. Maybe you can work 40 hours a week and your job has the option to drop down to 30 and do lawn care 30 hours a week. Then it's 20 and 50, and then it's 10 and 80, or whatever you guys wanna do. Maybe you can transition out that way. Now, if you have a wife and kids and mortgages and campers and RVs and boats, I don't know if going full-time in the lawn care is gonna be good for you your first year and expect to make 70 grand from your corporate job, making 70 grand doing lawn care landscaping. I don't know if that's really available. That's a tough business model. My friend Jonathan from Florida Turf Pros, he's got a great video. I'll link it at the end. He did that. He went from corporate America to lawn care, but it was a strategic, tactical, surgical decision that he did 3 years before learning the business to get out and go do lawn care landscaping. There's another guy out there, Danny with the Lanier Lawn Care. He makes a great point as well. Don't spend all of your time debating and watching lawn care setup videos. Who cares if it's Echo? Who cares if it's Steel? Who cares if it's Red Max? Get a trimmer, get a blower, get a mower, and go kick butt and take names. Most people spend so much time debating and being a fence post sitter that they don't have anything going on for themselves, and they're wondering why they're not making any money with their lawn care business. Be hot, be cold, but don't be lukewarm, okay? Another guy that makes some great advice, Naylor, Tefa, we don't know how to say your last name, Tino, okay? Long care rookie. I love my man Naylor, great guy. We got to meet him at Echo UAG, big fan, okay? Naylor right there, he says the same thing too. Get a trimmer, get a mower. Doesn't have to be a $5,000 stand-on mower, a $10,000. You don't need to buy a $15,000 lawnmower like I did, okay? Go buy a push mower, go buy a trimmer, and pass out flyers. Not postcards, doesn't have to be fancy. Just go do it. Okay, I'm telling you guys like a friend, figure out your expenses. Figure out the cost of running your business. Be somewhat logical, somewhat tactical. If you're not a numbers person, become a numbers person. If you're a numbers person, don't be a numbers person forever. Be a decision-making type of person. Be one that executes, okay? Whatever your personality flaw is, I don't like talking to people. Here's a tip, I don't like talking to people either, and I'm doing YouTube. It's called Facing Your Fears. Most of you guys, if you see me at GIE, I'm a hermit. I'm not gonna wanna come up and talk to you, so please come up and talk to me. But that's just my personality type. But I don't use it as an excuse to not go succeed doing YouTube, run my lawn and landscape business, make sales calls, make up sales calls, and everything in between. All right, most of you guys, you have the ambition, you're just not executing. And for those of you executing, you're just not thinking big enough. All right, so that's my two cents. You have gross revenue minus your expenses, that's your profit. When your profit equals what you make at your job, evaluate blowing that thing up. Now, I don't know if that's a decision you want to make in June, July, August when the season's already started. Frankly, I don't know if that's a decision you need to make at March, April, May. Make an educated decision. But you know what? If you have that passion in your mind, you have that passion in your heart where you're just sick and tired of being sick and tired and something's got to change, every day you get older, you have more opportunity that you lose. There's more responsibilities you're going to have. If you're 16 to 24 years old, man, make the decision and just go kick butt. If you're living at home, you got the world in front of your fingertips, you can get big like B&B Lawn Care. Fantastic, okay? If you're 30 years old, here's a tip. You're gonna be regretting not going full-time when you go 40 years old, and you have a mortgage, and you're hating the way your life turned out. Don't let that happen if you're on that path. Make a decision. Say, this is gonna be the year I'm gonna do something different. And you know what? Go kick butt and back things up. Here's my last part of it, and I'll let you guys know how I went full-time in lawn care. The first year I was doing business, I was working 3 days a week at a fertilizer company and 2 days doing lawn care. And this went on for about 3 or 4 months because I started my lawn care business in like July 2005 or 2006, whatever it was. The following spring, I was going back to my fertilizer company and I was gonna keep my same business model, doing True Green 3 days a week, cutting grass 2 days a week. Well, when we came back, we always do our early certificates and updates and seminars, whatever you guys wanna call it, at the office, and everybody gets retrained, right? That was in late February, early March. And they had already replaced a driver in my truck because they didn't think I was coming back because I was doing that lawn care thing, going full time, right? Well, here's a tip. I went back there in March. It was really awkward because I wasn't technically supposed to be there. And they kind of let me go. They basically said, look, we don't have a place for you. And I had about 6, maybe 7 weeks to basically figure out how to take what I had been making, equal it to what I was making at my job, that I had to equal now with my lawn and landscape business. So when I tell you guys, like a friend, that I passed out 5,000 flyers or whatever it was, hand delivered them, knocked on doors, beat the pavement, I had a major motivation. I didn't want to go back to a job. I didn't want to quit my lawn care business. So I had to figure out how to make my lawn care business pay for all my expenses. I figured it out. And that was 10 years ago. I didn't have YouTube. I didn't know anything about anything. And it's a miracle we even made it. I just had sweat equity. I was willing to fail. I was willing to laugh at myself along the way, still do, and we just figured it out, all right, guys? So what I'm trying to say is you might leave your job in a more strategic way, but at the same point, just figure it out. If I can do it, I promise you guys can do it. It's not as hard as you think, all right? So guys, kick butt, take names. Maybe I'll meet a guy one day at GIE and he says, look, I was inspired by your video. I was already making $1,200 a week doing lawn care. I was making $700 a week at my job. I decided to go full-time in lawn care, and this year we grossed 80,000 bucks. Fantastic, man. I'd love to meet that guy at GIE 1 year and say, because of a video like this, you went full-time. All right, guys. Hey, just want to inspire you. Again, all the trigger warnings that our society needs, unreal. Guys, make quality decisions. Figure out your numbers. Don't just fly off the bandwagon and just try to make stuff happen. Be surgical, be strategic, but nonetheless, you know what, you can still work your butt off and you can still make bad decisions and still figure things out. All right guys, if you enjoyed this video, shoot it a thumbs up. Maybe subscribe if you're new to the channel. If this is your first video, I apologize, you jumped on board when I was kind of rough, okay? Hey, appreciate you guys big time. The channel's blowing up. You guys are all awesome. Thank you so much for watching and subscribing. You guys take care and we'll catch you on the next one.